Hi guys, Todd here. Today we're going to be having a look at I'll tell you what, sod that. Back in time, August 2014, a long time ago now, I did a review for this. This was the 454 RDA, and for a long time, this was one of my go-to RDAs, and huge fan. When I got a squonking pin for it later down the line, fell in love with it again, and I think it is a tremendous RDA, and back in the day it was well ahead of its time. Anyway, fast forward to today, and Jay Haze, who's a reviewer in the States, collaborated with Raven's Moon, who made the 454, and they have now come up with the 502. Now, this is about $115 on a website that I'm on just now. You can also get it through a Facebook group as well if you want. I'll give you all the links in the description so you can go off and check it for yourself. This review, I do spend more time than I normally would on doing a rebuild. Now, that's not because this is difficult to build, it's just because it's different to what the current crop of RDAs are. So I can't just say, you know, throw a coil in, and not everybody has been vaping since August 2014. So here we go, close-ups. Now, I will point out that this one that I have here with me just now, this is a prototype version, and I do believe that it's very, very close, if not identical, to the final release version. But just be aware, this is the prototype. So you get this little bag of goodies. You've got Jay Haze and Raven's Moon here. But on the back, you'll see that it actually states what you are getting. And by that, I don't mean that it's just saying, yeah, we get a few O-rings and a few grub screws. Move that out the way. It's giving you the specifications, which 10 out of 10, you know, I tip my hat to the guy for coming up with that. That is a great idea. So you can go out and you can source these little parts yourself if you lose anything. Now, the RDA is 25 millimeters in diameter and about 24.5 millimeters in height. That's not including the 510, and it's not including the drip tip. The drip tip is an 810 affair, and the best of luck to you actually getting that drip tip off. Jesus Christ, what a job. It's in there tight, and it takes a lot of persuasion to get it out. Other 810 drip tips seem to go in no problem at all, but I would put some e-liquid on the O-ring that's inside here. It's a job and a half getting this off. I think the tolerances were just a bit out of whack on the drip tip there. As I said, it's stainless steel, and on the bottom we have 502. Once again, we've got Jay Haze logo, we've got Raven's Moon, and made in the USA. And we also have prototype number 9 there. Now, when this arrives with you, or certainly for my one, it was set up as a regular dripper, not a squonker. But one of the Allen keys, you will find, it's hard to see, but there was a little grub screw right inside there that I had to take out. Be careful, don't lose that little screw. Once you take it out, pop it in the bag, keep it safe. But you can see, you know, that it does protrude your 510 pin here, so all is good there. But you also notice that I can actually push the cap down. The cap goes down further than the base, so you do get it down tight onto your mod. So inside we have this, it's very different airflow. Well, actually, it's still a lie. I've seen it before in other things, but it's done slightly different here. But what happens is we have our top cap, and you can see here that we have dual, or we have single coil setups. So here's your airflow coming in from here, here, and here. And what happens is that you can see that we have an air slot here and an air slot here. So you basically just line up your air holes and you just pop that on like that. Now, this piece here, this black piece, is actually a hard aluminium. I think it's type 3. So if your coils touch off that, it's not going to short out or give you any issues. But if we look inside there, can you see that slot just there? And there's another one. So if I turn this around, you can see another slot there. So the air comes down these holes and then comes out of those slots. You can adjust the airflow, so I can just make sure I've got these lined up here, and I can spin that and I can adjust the airflow, and I can also run it as a single coil as well. If I run it as a single coil, so taking that single air hole there, popping that down, what happens is that this little tab here then blocks off one of the slots inside. The only thing I will say, be careful about. Now, this aluminium here is anodized, and so it's not going to short your coils out. But be careful, because this sits inside there. So if that gets moved about, and you can see it's just there, if that gets moved about and touches one of your coils, then yes, that will short out. So just bear in mind that that little tab is actually inside your chamber. Now for the deck itself, I think this is classic 454, but with a twist. The main thing here has got to be the actual center pin itself, especially when it comes to squonking. It's actually done really well. Basically what happens is when you squonk, juice is going to come up through this post here and will actually come out these two holes at the top, and there are holes at the bottom as well where the juice comes out. So when you squonk, push your squonk bottle, juice comes out the top and the bottom, but when it sucks it back, there's two little ball bearings inside that actually close the juice flow off at the top here, so that all that happens is it sucks all the excess back out of the well through the two holes at the bottom. It's very clever, it's well done, and once again I tip my hat to them for that one. Building on this is, it's going to be different for different people. I'm an old fart. I know I get the rip taken out of me for the way I build, but I've built on many, many devices. I've been building on 454s for a lot of years, and I don't find this thing to be an issue to build on. I really don't. Yes, it's slightly harder than other RDAs, but it's not impossible. It's just different. So all you do is you've got your Phillips screws here. So I just back one of them off on each side. I'm not going to unscrew it completely. On the other side, I am going to unscrew it completely. And then I just lift this up, spin that out like that, and just leave them hanging out like that, and then get my Allen key, and then I'm just going to go into the center one here, and I'm just going to back this little grub screw off here like that. I'm using these Geek Vape tidal coils, I think that's what they're called. I'm putting an extra half wrap on them so it'll come out hopefully about the 0.3 ohm. Builds and whatnot I will cover in the summary at the end. Now all I'm going to do here is I'm just going to pop one coil through there, ba-boom. I've got my other coil through, they're roughly in position, and then I'm just going to tighten that screw off. Then just snip off the excess, pull that one out the way, and snip there again. And then I'm just going to grab this, push that coil down a little bit, lift that over, and drop that into place. Give this a couple of little turns just to start it off. I'm not tightening this right down, and I'm doing the same with the other side as well. I'm then just going to take my coiling rod, and I'm going to put a little bit of an angle on these. I don't actually want them totally vertical. I just want, for me personally, I just put a tiny little bit of an angle on them. Then I'm going to snip my wires off here, make sure that you get them as close to that ring as you can. So that's my coils in, and as I said, you know, they've got a slight angle going on to them there. This came out at 0.3 on the nose. Now, what you want to do here is, and this is why I'm putting them at a slight angle, remember you've got the holes where the juice is going to come out the top. Well, the holes are also underneath where the coil sits. That's where the juice is going to come out. And you want to make sure that your cotton is not sitting right in front of those tiny little holes, well not tiny little holes, but holes that are at the bottom of the pin here underneath the coil. So what I do is I have the cotton come down through the coil into this well here and into this well here. Now you are going to need your ceramic tweezers or any tweezers that you have there, and I'm just grabbing the cotton here and I'm just slowly tweaking it down. And I just need enough, or I just use enough, just so that I'll fluff that out and it's just going to sit in this little well here like that. So what will happen is the juice will come out the hole at the bottom of the coil and then it will saturate and fill in here and soak the wick. Now the other thing you do now, and do you know that a nice good way to think about this is you've got four sections. So you've got a well here, coil, and coil. Now I've heard people saying that you could put four coils in this. Forget that. Don't bother. What you're going to do is you're going to take this cotton round here as well. So this whole area here, you know, the cotton's there. We're going to have cotton above as well. And then I'm going to prime this up. I'm just going to put some juice in this. And now that I've done that, I just kind of take my cotton and just spread this round here. Now, the other reason I like doing it this way is that it also reduces the, you know, the chamber inside. You know, it's taking some of the space out, which I think is going to help with the flavour as well. So, me personally, I think more cotton is better than less. And just to show you the squonking in action, so if I push here just now, see, they're just coming out the top, and it's just landing straight on there. And I don't know if you'll be able to see it, but can you see that juice coming out in the bottom there as well? And when I let go, all the excess is getting sucked straight back down into the bottle. I love this setup that he's got in here. So I've popped this onto a limelight gloom just now, and just, yep, she's good to go. So I'm going to take the top cap. Now the coils, take a note of where the coils are. Take a note of where the holes, you know, the slits are inside. See the slit there? One in the opposing side. So you want the slit to sit in front of the coil. So just line that up just now. Pop that down. There she goes. And then once again, take a note of where the air hole slots are here. And you want to line them up with, hope this shows up in the dark. See the two slits here? So we want them to line up and pop that over. And that's me good to go for a vape. I'll get this clear at the start, go off, and I will put links in the sidebar, or there'll be a little exclamation mark up in one of the corners. You can click that. Go and watch Jay's own video on his own RDA. He will show you how to build it as well. He will cover all the pros, cons, everything. And to be fair, he's probably harsher about his own product than I'm going to be. But this is just the way that I build it. This is just the way that I vape with it and what I think. But there are other reviews out there, and go and watch Jay's own method of building it. The way I built it is just based on 3 years of living with its little brother, the 454, and it's what works for me. And that's the thing, whatever works for you, go do it. If you want to throw in four coils in this thing, then you do it. It's your call. I'm not here to tell you what you should and shouldn't do. It's just an opinion. For me, straight off, to building it, very, very similar. It's very similar. If you can build a 454, you can build a 502. Quite frankly, I don't find it difficult in the slightest. It's something I'm used to. People that are coming from just standard 2-3 post RDAs might find it a bit tricky to begin with, but it's not a ball ache. It really isn't. And I do like the update to the design. I like the two, you know, clamps instead of having the one ring. That is an improvement over the original 454, so a thumbs up for that. A massive thumbs up has to be that squonk system. Those little ball bearings in there and distributing juice up the top and the bottom. Very clever, very well done, and it's the highlight of this RDA for me. I just think that's a really good design. I've got to give it to them for that. The looks once again, I mean, this is classic, and this, do you know, it's old school. To me, this just looks like a classic old school design. I mean, yeah, we're going for the whole, you know, 454 big block engine, 502 engine, you know, and you've got the pistons. That's where it's all coming from, and it works for me. I'm a petrol head. I love this kind of stuff. The fact that it comes with, you've got all those spares there, but the card that gives you all the technical spec on the spares, that's another big thumbs up. And yeah, I wish more manufacturers would actually do that, because it just makes it so much easier to go and find spares if you don't want to buy them direct from the manufacturer. The build quality on it, I like the build quality on it. It feels substantial. There's nothing flimsy about this. This is once again like the 454. It's a heavy bit of kit, and it just once again works for me. It then goes a little bit south after that, mainly because, number one, the drip tip. Getting the drip tip off, it's not easy.
you need tools, and I just think the tolerance is that they're out. That's my take on it, they're out. Other 810 drip tips go in no problem. I don't have an issue with it, but the one that comes with it, what a ball ache. The other thing is that I do not like, and this is personal taste here, I don't like RDAs where I cannot see the airflow adjustment. Now, I like the clean look, but not being able to see where to adjust the airflow by looking at it, never liked that design, and I don't like it on this. I don't like the fact that 9 out of 10 times I end up doing this, looking at this, and because this is black, this anodized bit in here, I'm like that and trying to line it up, and it's a pain in the arse. And also, I've got to say this, is that I think that was a fail, the fact that, you know, you've got that stainless steel section here. They've gone to the effort of, you know, coating this aluminium piece in here so you don't get any shorts from the coils. But then you've got this big lump of metal that's sitting inside there. If you spin it round by mistake, you will short out on your coil. I think that's an oversight. But I will say, in fairness, I'm 100% sure that I saw on Jay's own Facebook group that this is something they're aware of, and I think they will be addressing this down the line. I also think there may be updates, as in new caps and things like that as well. Not 100% sure, but there probably will be. Building on this, and with respect to coils, now coils wise, I would say you're going to be aiming 0.3 to 0.5 ohm. I've tried many builds in this, mainly because when I first got it and it arrived, I didn't like it. Flat out didn't like it. It didn't do it for me. The flavour was just not there. So I've possibly put more builds through this RDA than I normally would when I'm testing something, because I wanted to get it to be the best I could. Now, whilst I think the vapour production, bang on, the flavour for me just isn't great. I wanted it to be great. I wanted it to be as good as the 454. It's not. And that for me is my biggest con. I don't think the flavour production is as good as the 454. And I've tried as many builds. I've tried so hard. The other thing is that you have to give it more power. The 454, I can put a 0.3, 0.5 ohm build in that. I can vape it at 25, 30 watts and get great flavour and vapour production. With this, I have to go 30 to 50 watts. Obviously, it's a bigger chamber inside, but you have to give it more juice, more power to get a comparable vape to the old 454. And I don't think that's progress. I mean, the airflow is, you know, for me, that's a lung hit. And that's it fully open. There's a slight restriction there, but you can close it down so it's an even tighter draw. Nothing like mouth to lung, just a tight lung hit. But fully open suits me fine on this. And just giving it a blast just now, once again, I'm at 50 watts and a 0.3 ohm build. It's not bad. I've been completely honest. It's not bad. It's just not as good as I hoped it would be. I mean, this is 30 watts and a 0.33 build. It's just better. There's no two ways about it. I can get a better vape from this. Listen, I don't know if it's fair me comparing this to a 3-year-old Atty. I don't know, but that's just the way I've done it. I will tip, do you know, kudos to the guy. He could have slapped his name on any piece of shit and just cashed in. I mean, like some reviewers are doing, but he's not. He's gone down a different route. And I tip my hat to him for that. I really do. And fair dues for giving it. This may work for some people. I actually personally really like the RDA. I just wish the flavour was just a bit better. If it was, I would be giving this a thumbs up. As it stands up now, I would possibly say just go and buy yourself an old 454. But if you like putting lots of power and lots of juice through something to get a certain type of vape, bash on. If you're just an old fat like me, go and buy a 454 and you'll be just as happy. I'll finish this off by saying thank you to Jay for sending this on. I do appreciate that. And yeah, go and watch other reviews. There's lots of them out there now. Go and watch Jay's original video describing it and how to set it up. And that's it from me, guys. Until next time, bye for now.